Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 10.3, Problem 5. This is Section 10.3, Problem number 5. It says the Block Island Ferry Company claims to have a mean travel time of mu equal to 30 minutes. One of the regular passengers suspects that the average ferry ride lasts longer than 30 minutes. With the aid of a stopwatch, this passenger observes a sample mean of x bar equal to 31 minutes and a sample standard deviation of s equal to 3.5 minutes during a sample of 49 ferry trips. Is there enough evidence to support the passenger's conjecture at a 5% level of significance? So this is a hypothesis test. Step one, state the null hypothesis. So the symbol for null hypothesis is a capital H with a subscript of zero. You put a colon, you put mu, you can have a number and some condition of equality. It could be equal to, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to. In this case, it'll be equal to 30. That's step one, null hypothesis, mu equals 30. Step two, state the alternate hypothesis. So you'll have a capital H with a subscript of one. You put the colon again. The mu, the same number, but there'll be a different symbol besides equal. So what are we testing here? This passenger feels that the average is really more than 30, that the Block Island Ferry Company is sort of trimming it down a little bit to make it sound good. He thinks it's really a little bit bigger. So now the next step, step three, determine what type of test you have. Is this a left tail test, right tail test, or two tail test? And it depends on the symbol that you're using in the alternate hypothesis. I have a greater than symbol. It points to the right. So this is a right tail test. Less than would be left, not equal to would be two tail. But this one is greater than. Greater than points to the right. So this is a right tail test. And what that means is when we see the graph, the critical region will be on the right. And this is a 5% level of significance, so we want to see if we get into the rightmost 5% of that graph. That's going to be the question. So the next step, step four, is compute the value for t. Now I'm computing t because I don't know the standard deviation of the entire population. If I happened to know that, I would compute z. That's a little bit different. But because it's the standard deviation of the sample that I'm dealing with, I want to compute t. So t equals x bar minus mu over s divided by square root of n. Now to fill in this formula, I'll have t equals first x bar. So x bar is given at 31. Minus mu, the value of mu I can see is 30. Then in the denominator, s, the standard deviation of my sample, is 3.5. And then divided by square root of n. N is the size of the sample, how many items in the sample. This particular problem has a sample size of 49. There were 49 ferry trips that this passenger kept track of the time. So 49 items in the sample, that means the value of n is 49. Don't forget the square root. That's a fairly common mistake. Now the formula's filled in. Let's do out the computation. So in the numerator, 31 minus 30 is just 1. That's easy enough. And in the denominator, I'll have 3.5 over 7. Because the square root of 49 is 7. And now I can simplify that denominator. 3.5 divided by 7 is going to give me 0.5. So my computation for t is 1 over 0.5. And to figure that out, you can do that on the calculator. 1 divided by 0.5 is 2. So my value for t is 2. So now the question is, does the 2 push us out into the critical region? Or does it stay a little before the critical region? So what we have to do is see what the critical value of t would be that makes the boundary between the non-critical and critical part of the graph. So the question said use a 5% level of significance. So you're going to go to that student t distribution at the end of the homework assignment. Find the 0.05 column on that chart. You want to find the right row. So the row you look for is one less than the size of the sample. The size of our sample is 49. One less than 49 would be 48. So you want to look for the 48 row. And what you'll find is that there is no 48 row. And sometimes, as the sample sizes get bigger, that will happen. So when it does happen, what you want to do is find where the row would be if it was in the chart and go to the next biggest one that really is in there. So there is no 48, but there is a 50. That would be the next biggest one if they did list all the rows. So we can't quite find 48. 50 is the closest next biggest one. So we're going to go to the row with 50. Now, where the row with 50 degrees of freedom intersects the column with 0.05 level of significance, the number for that is 1.676. That's my critical value, 1.676. So 2 goes past it. We've gone well into the critical region. So my conclusion is reject the null hypothesis. So if I reject the null hypothesis, that means I'm saying it's more likely that the alternate hypothesis is the one that's correct. Again, it's never really a guarantee, but it's more likely to be true that the real average is more than 30 minutes. So the last step, state your conclusion at step 6. Your conclusion would be reject null.